Hi, this is Darko. I would like to give you a walkthrough of Daedalus 2.4.0. This new version of Daedalus continues to improve the delegation user experience. It brings a saturation indicator for stake pools to show how close to saturation a pool is getting. It also adds a potential rewards estimation based on the amount of stake you intend to delegate. There is a new table view for easier stake pool comparison. And to help you better understand the key metrics, we've added tooltips with explanations for all stake pool attributes. Let's jump to the stake pool screen and see this in action. The first change you can notice here is the saturation indicator on the stake pool tiles, and also here in the stake pool details. It is a visual representation of the saturation level of a pool. To help understand what saturation and other stake pool attributes are, we have introduced tooltips here in the stake pool details, explaining all of the attributes. As you can see here, saturation measures the amount of stake in the pool and it indicates the saturation point of 100%. At this point, rewards stop increasing with increases in stake, so you should avoid pools at more than 100%. Because of this reward capping mechanism, which is in place to support the decentralization of the system, the saturation bar is green for pools that are up to 100% saturated. It gradually changes from green to yellow as pools go above 100% saturation level. At this point, your maximum rewards will level out and then start to decline. An orange bar means more saturation and progressively lower rewards. Finally, the bar becomes red when pools reach a saturation level of more than 110%. If you want maximum rewards, you should avoid delegating to oversaturated pools. So make sure you keep an eye on the saturation level indicator for the stake pools you are delegating to. The ranking will also help you in this situation, since pools will get lower ranking as they get more oversaturated. We also have an important change in the ranking system. The ranking is no longer shown for pools that will earn zero rewards for the stake you have selected in the stake slider. Remember, the ranking is ordering of pools based on the rewards you will potentially earn per epoch from the amount of stake you intend to delegate. For the default selection of 1000 in the stake slider, I can see that some pools don't have a ranking, because potential rewards are zero for those pools. You can now see the potential rewards here in the stake pool details. Potential rewards are an estimate and based on the all stake pool parameters and attributes and the historical performance data, assuming that the pool will reach optimal saturation. We also have a brand new table view for stake pools. You can switch between the tile and the table view using these icons on the right. All of the stake pool attributes are displayed here in the table view for easier comparison. And we also have the explanation tooltips here in the table header. By default, stake pools are ordered by their ranking here in the table view. The amount of stake that goes into this calculation is currently set to 1000 by default in the stake slider. The ranking system is estimating potential rewards of 0.7 ADA per epoch for the top-ranked pool. You can notice that potential rewards are lower for stake pools with a lower ranking. I can use the Select Wallet dropdown to select the amount of stake in all of my wallets or in just one of my wallets. When I select a wallet, the ranking and the rewards are recalculated based on the amount of stake I have in the selected wallet. This wallet has only 48 ADA, so displayed rewards are now lower. I can also move the stake slider to see the rewards for an arbitrary amount of stake. When I move it to 100,000, I can see that I can potentially expect 77 ADA in rewards per epoch from the top-ranked pool. To be clear, this number is not exact, it is an estimate. The amount of stake for pools changes with every delegation and redelegation in the system, and pools can perform differently than they did in the past. They could also be offline when they need to produce blocks, which would impact their rewards negatively. The ranking system uses performance data from all epochs, but recent epochs impact the ranking more than earlier epochs since they are weighted more heavily in the ranking calculation. I can also order pools by any parameter displayed in the table view in ascending or descending order. Let's look at pools with the highest pledge amounts. Pledge is the amount of stake that the pool operator contributes to the pool. In most cases, this comes from their own personal ADA holdings. To reward this commitment to the ecosystem, pool operators with higher pledge amounts earn more rewards for themselves and for their delegators, impacting their ranking positively. But pools that don't honor their pledge will earn zero rewards and will not have a ranking. In the next Daedalus update, we will explicitly show which pools have not met their pledge. Until then, you can rely on potential rewards, which will be zero for those pools, so they will also not have a ranking. We have covered the ranking, potential rewards which give us ranking, saturation and pledge. Let's go to the rest of the columns in the table view. You can also see which pools are retiring and when will they stop operating. Here is the total number of blocks a pool has produced in its lifetime. Profit margin is a percentage of the rewards earned from delegated stake, which is kept by pools. And the cost is a fixed amount of ADA retained by the pool from any rewards earned during the epoch before the rest of the rewards are distributed to delegators. You can also click the stake pool ticker to open a detailed view which also has the pool description and the website URL. Hopefully, the new table view will help you decide on which pool to delegate. When you decide, you can initiate the delegation wizard by clicking the Delegate to this pool button here in the detail view. Thanks for watching, and we hope you will enjoy the updated delegation user experience. And keep an eye on the upcoming updates, which will bring hardware wallet support to Daedalus.